Here's the new year, and naturally, new challenges are coming up. And of course your requests are also coming up for what kind of dogs and dog breeds you would to see in a video. We thought it might be worthwhile to start the year by looking at last year's requests and trying to respond to some of the previous requests as well. Well, it was also a surprise to us that one of the most stable and most frequent requests since the start of this channel was to talk about band dogs and, as far as possible, center the topic around of who they are and what they have been used and are being used around the world. This part will be about them, the mysterious band dogs. Stay tuned if you're curious about band dogs too. First, it should be noted that band dogs have never been an independent dog breed or a uniform dog type. Nevertheless, they have a long history, and the information related to them are customarily mixed in human heads. Let's try to fix this issue first. If we talk about band dogs, we need to separate two eras or two periods in terms of their history and creation. The first of these is the Middle Ages, when the name band dog was actually born. According to linguists, the name is believed to have been born in the 14th century England and originally appeared as a bond dog, or band dog, which specifically meant a dog kept on a leash. According to the descriptions, this term was used to refer to dogs that were kept on a chain during the day because of their dangerous nature, but were released at night to protect an area or property. This is not an overly detailed information, but that is actually almost all that is known about these dogs, and no more, given that dog breeds in general did not even exist until the end of the 19th century, early 20th century. Sinologists say that the medieval band dogs might have been among the ancestors of modern bulldogs and modern mastiffs. And then, the second era, or the modern period of their development. The history of so-called modern band dogs began in the 1960s when a U.S. veterinarian, John B. Swinford, began experimenting with mixing several dog breeds. As a veterinarian, Swinford saw the steady decline of several dog breeds, especially mastiffs, and he began mixing dogs with the goal of creating a healthy, agile type of dog with superb working abilities, but at the same time with a large body. No one knows exactly what dogs or dog breeds he used in the process, but most sinologists think that the American Pit Bull Terrier and Neapolitan Mastiff hybrid or mix might have been the basis. Equally likely are the American Pit Bull Terrier and English Mastiff or American Pit Bull Terrier and Bull Mastiff mixes. In any case, he created a type of dog that quickly gained a good reputation, and after the veterinarian's death in 1971, they began to be called Swinford band dogs in canine circles. Although band dogs were not adopted as a standalone breed then or since, these dogs became increasingly popular, first in America, and then gradually in Europe, and then, all over the world. Many breeders have experimented with mixing different varieties and breeds, so the band dogs are not uniform at all. There are serious differences in sizes and colors, and it is difficult to determine exactly who they really are. Perhaps the most accurate definition seems to be the following. The band dog is a mixed dog type that comes from a mix of a mastiff and a bull type of dog, most commonly an American Pit Bull Terrier. The most common types of band dogs are the Pit Bull Neapolitan Mastiff mixes, the Pit Bull Bull Mastiff mixes, who are also known as the Pit Bull Mastiff in America, but there are many examples of Dogue de Bordeaux dogs, English Mastiffs, American Bulldogs, Dogo Argentinos and Great Danes and other large dogs breeds are being mixed. The goal in almost every case is to mix the toughness, the healthiness, and the agility of the pit bulls with the size, the power, the bite strength, and human-loving nature of mastiffs. Although, as mentioned earlier, there is no uniform band dog, and their definition is not simple, the keeping of these dogs is prohibited in many countries because of their pit bull ancestor, although we would be extremely curious as to how and on what basis a local public servant or policeman could identify and isolate a band dog from other mixed dogs. This is here now, the place of clumsy head scratching. A few words about the average size of the band dogs. Band dogs are usually large, full-muscled dogs, but they cannot be sluggish or slow. If averages can be drawn at all, males typically weigh 100 to 140 pounds and females weigh more than 85 to 90 pounds, with an average height at the withers of around 23 to 28 inches. There is a lot of talk in the English-speaking dog literature about the excellent abilities of band dogs, and the general opinion is that they are excellent protection and bodyguard dogs with above-the-average physical abilities, power and strength, who, however, can be quite aggressive with other dogs, partly because of their pit bull terrier ancestors. Nor should it be forgotten that all of the ancestors, whether we talk about mastiffs or pit bull terriers carrying terrier blood, are quite stubborn in nature, which is also typical of band dogs. Therefore, these dogs are not recommended at all for beginner dog keepers, mimosa souls, people in a weak physical condition, and fellow human beings with unstable personalities. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and do not forget to hit that bell button. Thank you very much for your attention.